Hello everyone, welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store of the series Do It Yourself. And today we are going to continue with the topic that we saw a few years ago about how to calculate the P&L with Builder. Today we are going to add how to calculate the daily P&L, because we saw that on Builder the number that we can get from the reports on Builder is the total P&L. So we are going to need a counter, something that we saw on the previous video. And first of all, we need some signals for the test strategy. And for that, we are going to use this new indicator. A lot of people is asking me how to automate an indicator. So this is we are going to do both. We are going to explain how to automate this or any indicator. This is a new goodies indicator, the goodies trend. Goodies trend includes a filter like this one. The black line is a linear regression, and it filters the signals with the slope. We can make it slower, like this. So we only get signals in the same direction as the slope of the black line. But for this example, we want a lot of signals, no filter. And those signals are going to be just an example, because what we want to do is to calculate the daily P&L of those signals. As you can see, this indicator uses triangles, plots. And today we are going to explain how to automate any indicator that uses plots. We can see that those are plots. The plot style is a triangle up for longs, a triangle down for shorts, but it can be any shape. So let's create a builder. We go to new strategy builder as usual. Choose a name. For this example, I am going to use width and the name of the indicator. Goodies trend. We are going to work at our close. By now we are not using this, but this is something that we are going to add to complete today's goal. By now, just we are going to explain how to detect and automate the signals. So on all strategies, we need a target and the stop. We can place any number for the target, because this is something that the user can change, and also we can optimize with the analyzer. With only that, then we can detect and automate any indicator. What I need is this plot can have a value. If it is present, it has a value. Currently, the value of that plot is the price where it is drawn. And to check if that it exists, I can test if it is greater than zero. When it is not present, when it do not exist, I cannot say that it is equal to zero, because it is not equal to nothing. So I don't have a condition to check that it do not exist. But I can check that it exists by just checking if it is greater than zero, not equal to zero, whatever. But be careful, because if you are using an indicator that can paint plots negative, then you will need to change the logic to something like different than zero, for example. But for this example, just knowing that the plot is greater than zero, that's enough. So my condition for longs is that this plot that is present on the indicator. You can choose whatever, any indicator that you want. But for this example, we are going to use the goodies trend. It has two parameters, the period and if you want to use a filter or not. On this example, we are not going to use parameters. And also the plots. The plot I want is the triangle for longs, and the name of that plot is signal up. I want this to be greater or equal or greater, but not equal to zero. So we can set numeric value zero. And here you select the indicator and the corresponding plot, and of course all the parameters. And that means that we have a triangle. We have a blue triangle. You can add more conditions. And now, just for checking, I want to paint something on the chart. For example, drawing the background with a pale color, something like this. Just for checking that it is correct. For the shorts, I can duplicate the logic, change the color, of course, to something like this. This. And for the logic, the indicator is the same, but we are looking at a different plot. So we edit, don't change the parameters, but only we need to change the plot. The right side is the same because we are only testing that it exists. So greater than zero, different than zero, whatever. And here we change the plot. Now we are looking at the down signals. The name of the plot may be different on another indicator. This is something that you will need to check. And now, if this indicator is compatible, it can be read from another indicator or strategy, most of the indicators are, then we can compile and test if it works. Now we can add the strategy to the chart. And it should paint the background when there is a signal. The name of the strategy is with Woody's Trend. We enable, and here we can see that it is painting the background exactly at the same places where the indicator is painting signals. It is not necessary to have the indicator because it is not related at all. Even more, if the indicator has different parameters from the strategy, the signals are not going to be the same, so be careful with that. If your indicator has parameters, set the parameters to the same value of your indicator. Now, let's continue with today's topic, how to calculate the daily profit. We need to execute an order now, each time that we have a signal. So when we paint a blue background, we add an enter long. And when we paint a red, enter short. And now that we have orders, we need target and stops. This is on the following page. Click on Add. Profit target in ticks defined by the input parameter target. And a stop in ticks defined by the input parameter stop. And now we can compile again, but I am forgetting something. Before doing something else, I don't want to have real-time orders while I am working on the strategy. So let me add just, I only want to place order if I am on historical, because we are creating a strategy by now. I don't want have order pending on the live market while I am finishing the logic. So we can add another condition for the longs and the shorts that it is on miscellaneous current state. The current state can have the value historical or live. So current state is equal to state historical. I don't want real time trace. I can copy this to the other condition. So both shorts and longs must be on historical. So now we have two conditions. I have a signal and also I am on historical. And now refresh the strategy, disable and enable. And now we can see the orders. But I need the orders to be bigger. More than one bar of duration, because I want to calculate when the trade has finished, and that this may take more than one bar. So let's use a bigger target and stop. Something like, the horizontal lines are 10 ticks, so let's use 20. So we are sure that it is not going to end or finish, it is not going to finish on the same bar, like here. We have an entry and an exit on a different bar. Now I need to calculate where is the exit bar. So I calculate at that place the daily PNL. So I need to detect when the trade has finished. So we add another tab and we can use the function. It is on miscellaneous bars signs exit. The result of this function is minus one if there was no trades at all, or the number of bars signs the lax exit. For example, if the current bar has an exit, then the result is zero. But if the result is 5, that means that 5 bars ago there was an exit for my last trade. I want to use 0 because I want to detect when on my current bar there is an exit. So if it is equal to miscellaneous numeric value 0, let's draw the background in black so we can check. Or no, much better, let's draw a text, for example, an X letter. Draw text, and at the top of the bar, maybe the high plus 5 ticks. This distance is 10 ticks, so half of the distance between the horizontal lines, 5 ticks. And for the text, let's place an X, just for checking if it is detecting the exit of a trade. For the tag, don't forget, for all the objects, we need to add something that changes, because this is the name of the object, and this must be different on each bar. So we can add something that changes, for example, the current bar, and it is inside miscellaneous. Current bar. Okay, and with this, it should place an X at the top of each end of trade. Compile again and refresh to check. Here is an X because this is the exit of a trade. And for the long, here is the X. It is overlapping with the profit. We can place it higher on the following run. So these are the places where I want to calculate the new PNL. But let's place them 10 ticks far from the bar. The only result that we have available from NinjaTrader on Builder is the total PNL, the total of the chart. So let me show you. Instead of placing an X, the vertical axis was deleted. It was high plus 5. Now I want to use high plus 15. High plus 15 ticks. So it is far enough from the text. The tag is okay. But instead of drawing an X, let's draw the only value that we have available on Ninja. It is inside strategy. At the bottom, we have released PNL and unreleased PNL. Unrealized P&L is obvious. It is the current trade, but we don't have a current trade because we are checking that the last trade has finished. But the released P&L is the realized P&L of the total strategy. Not from today, not from this week. It is from the total chart, no matter how many days it has. But let's take a look. Compile. And now let's see how it looks. Disable and enable again. And this number is the P&L, not the daily P&L, the total P&L of all the chart until now. If we go to the beginning of the chart, we can see that the first trade is almost 100. It is deducting commissions because this is a trade of $100. The second trade is 200. But the problem is there is never a reset because this is what we get on Builder from the strategy performance on this function, the system performance cumulative profit. Now, how can I reset that? Let's, first of all, we need to define where I want to reset that counter. Usually at the end of the day, or maybe at the end of the session. One of the possible ways is, let's go to the start of the day. We are starting the day here. At some moment, at some time, we need to reset this number to zero. But this number, I cannot reset this number because this is the result reported by NinjaTrader. So I need a counter, or I need a variable where I store the last result on the previous day. Because if I know that this number, this is the last P&L from yesterday, and then when I calculate the new P&L, this for example, I subtract that number, then I get today P&L, because one minus the other, the today P&L, the current P&L minus yesterday P&L is today P&L, that's of course. So I need to subtract one with another, but I need to store yesterday P&L into a variable. But first of all, I need to know when to reset the day or whatever, or the session, or the week, or the month, or whenever I want to reset my counter. For today, we are going to use the session. There is a function on miscellaneous where we can test if this is the first part of session. It can be true or false. And depending on the session that you have on the chart, it can be the new day, the end of day session, and it starts the extended session, or the change between 0, the 23:59 to 0000. That depends on your day session. Now let's paint the background in black when that happens. When the first part of session is true. Let's compile this to check if that works for this example. Now we refresh the chart. And here is the black line at the end of the session. This is between August 9 and August 10, and the previous here is from August 8 and 9. So that's okay. That's the perfect place to reset the counter or to store the previous day P&L. So now what I need is a variable where I store the P&L reported by Ninja at the end of the session here. Then I subtract that value from each reported value, so I have an idea which is today's P&L. So I need a variable, and it needs to have decimals because it is a double. And let's use the name yesterday P&L, something like that, because this is the use of the variable. On that variable, we are going to hold the P&L from yesterday. So let's use P&L underscore yesterday. A double with the default values of zero. And I need to set that variable each time there is a new session. So I have longs, shorts, when I calculate the end of the trade. And here, where I detect the first bar of the session, I paint the background in black and I also update the value of this new variable. Set PNL yesterday is equal to whatever reports NinjaTrader. So strategy released PNL in currency format. And what else? I want to check. At some point, I am going to need the daily PNL. So I need a variable with the daily PNL. Here I cannot subtract this value with the variable. Let's take a look. Here, when I use the reported released PNL, there is no space here with an offset where I can subtract or add anything. So I need to subtract what happened yesterday, and this is not possible here. So I need another variable, but a variable where I can subtract or add something. And we saw that on the previous session about counters. The only variable where we can add or subtract are data series. We can add or subtract only to data series, not to variables. This is on Builder. It is a limitation of Builder. So let's go back. Another step back. And here on custom series, we are going to create a data series for today PNL. It is a double, and I am going to hold here the PNL for today. Something that we always need to do when we use a data series is to set the value at the beginning. Here we have a variable and a data series, and we can see the difference. A variable has only value. A data series has value and bars ago. And each new bar, we need to set a value, even if it is zero. We need to reset the value for each new bar. So at the beginning of the bar, we set the today's PNL equal to zero. This is the first thing we do always. We set the data series equal to zero. Then, when I have a finished trade, this is drawing something that we don't need this. By now, let's set the new data series, the PNL for today, on the current bar, and here we set whatever reports NinjaTrader as P&L. But now I can add another step where I set exactly again the same. I assign value to P&L today on the current bar is equal to himself, the same variable, plus something. So we set custom series, P&L today, on the current bar, and here we have an offset. So here we can subtract and yesterday P&L. Here. Okay. Okay. It looks crazy, but this is how what we can do on Builder. We assign the value of the vector with whatever reports NinjaTrader has daily performance. And then we assign the value to itself minus yesterday P&L. We can remove this. We don't need this anymore. And repaint it again. Let's draw the text with the new variable. So let's draw a text. Also at the high plus 15 ticks. We need to add the current bar to the tag. And finally, the text is just the variable. Instead of the reported value by Ninja, the recently calculated variable, the P&L today. So set custom data series, it is inside miscellaneous, custom series, P&L today, on the current bar with no offset. We can also place the offset here, so we avoid one step, but the problem is usually this variable, the P&L today, is useful because we need to check to test it against the maximum daily loss and maximum daily profit. So this is the preferred way to do it. So now we are drawing today's P&L. Let's see if it works. And now that it is compiled, we can refresh, enable again. Now let's take a look at the reported values. Here we have 6,000. And here we should reset. And now, here, we have 96, almost $100. Another long, 192. So this is okay. Now we have two winners, almost $200. So this is correctly resetting the counter at each new day. Let's test another day. For example, here. Here the count reads 800. Now it should reset. And now we have a short with a profit of 96, almost 100. A long with a profit 192, almost 200. And now we got the daily P&L. Reset at the place we want. Currently at the session, at the first bar of the session. But here we can place time checking, for example, when the time is greater than something. Another thing that I can do is a counter of winners and losers. With what we have here, we have almost everything, because on this tab, where we know that a trade is finished, then we calculate the new daily P&L. And we could store the previous daily P&L, so we can compare the previous with the current. And if the difference is positive, then we have a new winner if the difference is negative, we have a new loser, and with that info, we can increase one or another counter. This is a good topic for another video. But with what we saw today, we can do almost everything. Of course, that if we look at the code, if we use NinjaScript, we have many more options. It is much easier if we know NinjaScript. But for more detailed info, a video will take a lot more time. The info that we have available with this instruction is we have a much more combinations, a lot of more info than what we have on Builder. But this is what we have on Builder. Even so, as you can see, using data series and variables, we can do almost everything. We can calculate today's P&L, the last trade P&L, whatever. Hope this video has been useful for you. Any question or comment, you can find me on the chat room. Or if you want to learn more, we are doing training sessions all weeks, not only about Builder, but also markers and NinjaScript. There is much more potential. For more info, contact me on the chat room. The instructions to enter the chat room are on the description of this video. Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.